we don't have time for the other two panelists. So we have 5 minutes to take a few questions. Please raise your hand. First one is Dr. Chen.
Mr. Chairman, I would like to make an appeal and to ask a question. Someone coming from Hong Kong, I do admit that Hong Kong people, despite their high education levels and so on, may have a lot of improper attitudes towards various groups. And it is largely a matter of bad habits, incorrect values, and so on. My appeal is simple. Please make a distinction between the government and the people. I understand that sometimes we have wrong impressions, wrong attitudes, like we use the word minorities and so on, which may cause resentment. Say, Hong Kong people normally have no bad feelings against Tibetans and Great Wales. We normally think Great Wales as very handsome men and very beautiful women. On the other hand, Hong Kong people sometimes look down on their mainland brethren and sisters, and we do have a lot of disrespect, improper attitudes towards Falun Gong followers and Taiwan independence followers and so on. What I'm trying to say is simple. Please make a distinction between the authorities and the people. We all need to be educated so that we may learn to treat people properly. Sometimes we are misled by the authorities. Sometimes we don't behave as suggested by the authorities. For example, I understand that Chinese university students normally do not have a very proper attitude towards African students, although they are told to be very friendly to the African students. I just want to quote from the Bible. I think when our Lord Jesus Christ was about to be crucified, he prayed to God the Father, and he said, "Forgive them, Father, for they know not what they do." Sometimes we don't have the bad feelings. It is simply ignorance.
Thank you.
I just would like to raise one question, and I would like to seek enlightenment on the relations between the Uyghurs in Xinjiang and the other ethnic groups like the Kazakhs and Tajiks and Uyghurs.
I'd like to refer the question to
1 minute each.
Actually, we have a very good relationship with other groups like Tajiks, and Tajiks is they live in a very in a certain area. They don't live all over Xinjiang, the Uzbekistan. They live in they call it Tajik Autonomous County. It's very close to Afghan border. We have a lot of Uyghurs live there, and traditionally we look like brothers, and there is no problem. And with the Kazakhs and the Kyrgyz and also, but after communists take over in 1949, and they intentionally trying to divide the people, and they discord among the people, and in that way they can divide and rule. So actually, Kazakhs and the Kyrgyz, we belong to, we're culturally the same, and they just live in the mountains. We live in the villages at the foot of the mountains, and traditionally. Before this Kazakh and Uyghur term applied to the different groups of people, actually we usually didn't differentiate among ourselves, and we are the same people. So there is no discord. Actually, when the Chinese arrived in the first time, before the communists came, we welcomed them. Otherwise, if we reacted violently like Iraqis and like other groups, there wouldn't be any Chinese over there now. We welcome them, and we welcome, it's very, if you look at the racial features of the Uyghurs there, people look like Europeans, look like the Asian, and look like also some Indians. That's very tolerant people throughout the history, and we welcome different people in our communities. And even when I grew up there, I had a lot of Chinese friends, and my father had a lot of Chinese friends, but because recently, because the Chinese government, especially after in Cultural Revolution, everybody suffered. Chinese suffered, we suffered. And after the 1980s, And Chinese policy turned from a turned and then it became an ethnocentric and favoring the ethnic Chinese over Uyghurs. So there, the discord started, deep discord among ordinary people. So I would say we have a very good relationship with all the ethnic groups, and the discontent, discord among the ethnic groups actually created by Chinese government.
That's enough. Give a more chance to ask
one more question.